Friday, Mix 97. Hey, it's MJ. 11 past 1, I'm ready. Now, if you love hearing that song on the radio, just wait, because you're going to get to hear it live. I've got all the guys here right now. Do you want to introduce yourselves?
Yeah, what's up? I'm Daniel.
I'm Kyle. I'm Steve-O.
And I'm Steve.
And we're 11 past 1.
There's two Dans and two Steves.
Yeah. I'm the only Kyle, but...
Does it ever get confusing?
No, because I switched my name to Steve-O so that the Steves are out of the way. And then we usually call Dan, and we call Dan BD. So
all right, I get it. That's
it's
cool.
Like BD, Dan, Kyle, Steve-O. Yeah.
Okay, and I hear you guys have a new Christmas song that you're going to play for us right now.
Yeah, it is. We actually made video 14. You can find it on YouTube. And it's also on iTunes. It's called Merry Christmas to Everybody.
Okay, I'm going to get you to switch over to that mic, because that one's not working, apparently. And you're the singer, so we kind of have to hear you. No, I don't think so.
At all?
All right, there we go. We're going to do some shifting around.
All right.
There we go. Okay.
Okay, we're in business. Yeah, so this is the acoustic version. Of Merry Christmas to everybody.
Are you hanging up a stocking on your wall? Is it time that every Santa has a ball? Does he ride a red-nosed reindeer? Does he turn upon his sleigh? Do the fairies keep him so before the day? So here it is, Merry Christmas, everybody's having fun. Look to the future now, it's only just begun.
Nice. Okay, now you can go over there. Sweet. All right. Good job, guys. That was amazing.
Thanks a lot.
scale these levels back up here.
Do you guys like it over there? You like it?
Awesome. We've got the best little audience in here today.
I was just going to say, it's like a little concert.
Yeah, it's awesome.
I got to say, honestly, one of my favorite things about you guys is your fans, because they're amazing.
They're the best.
They're extremely loyal, and they follow you guys everywhere. And like, I heard about I'm Ready before I even knew about it. Like, really? I heard about it on Twitter.
Oh, I know.
Before I got it, which is amazing. Awesome.
It's because of these guys right here.
Yeah, so keep, give yourselves a round of applause. Yes. Yeah. All right, so here's the thing. I'm not very good at interviews, so I decided why not let your fans kind of decide what they wanted to know about you guys. So I actually got these guys to come up with some questions to ask you, and I want them to ask you themselves so they can kind of take credit for their own questions.
Awesome.
So can I get our first winner, Abby Bain, over here?
Abby Bain.
What's up, Abby? What's going on? Hey.
Hey, Abby, I'm going to give you my microphone, okay? Here you go. So what do you want to ask the guys?
I was wondering how old you guys were when you decided you wanted to be performers.
Oh my gosh.
That's a good question, actually.
I don't know. I don't know the exact age, but I was very young. I mean, my mom says she knew I was going to be a performer when I was in my diapers singing Skidamarinky Dinky Dink in front of the TV. Sharon
Lewis
and Bram show,
that?
The elephant show. I don't know if there's a video, but I don't know.
Yeah, that's like me too. Like, I had a little Fisher-Price xylophone piano thing, and I guess I was watching TV, and a song came on the, one of the commercials, and I started to play it, like, probably with a lot of mistakes, but I was trying to play it anyways, and then that's when they knew they should put me in piano lessons, and then, yeah, as far as I can remember, I've always wanted to do music and be a performer.
I used to jump around on my parents' couch listening to Bon Jovi albums when I was, like, 2 or 3, but, I mean, started playing an instrument when I was 9.
I was performing. I'd do like little lip sync concerts for my parents when I was on like this little Fisher Price like picnic table, the orange and yellow one. So I was like 3, maybe 4.
I had the plastic guitars, you know, the ones with the buttons. And
yeah, I love those too.
My parents put me into violin lessons at like the age of 4, so I could read music before I could actually read.
Yeah, it's been a while, that's for sure.
Right.
Good question.
Thank you very much, Abby.
Thank you.
All right, next up we have Jacqueline.
Come Jacqueline.
Am I saying that right?
Jacqueline or Jacqueline?
My question is, how did you guys come up with your band name?
I also want to know that really badly.
Well, really, it started off by seeing it daily on the clock, 11 past 1, spontaneously, sporadically, whatever you want to put it. And then we were just about to go on tour, and we didn't have a name for our band yet. And we were sitting around a table late at night. We were shooting out, like, every single name we can even think of, like...
Yeah, we were putting...
We were just being stupid, like, coffee table, lamp. Like, we were just throwing out crazy names. And we looked at the clock, and we're like, it's getting late. It's 11 past 1. We're like, wow, we see that all the time. And then we put that out, you know, in the air. We're like, wow, that sounds kind of good. So it kind of stuck.
Yeah. Now, we see it everywhere. We go, we see it everywhere.
And you'll start seeing it, too.
Yeah. Oh, whoa, okay.
Yeah.
Not the time, either. All right, so next up we have Haley Loft.
What's up, Haley?
What's up?
Coming over here, Haley. Hey. Don't be shy.
What was your most favorite song to write?
I've never heard that question before.
I haven't. No, I haven't heard that one either.
These are good questions. Favorite song to write?
World Is Ours.
Yeah, the World Is Ours.
I think that was really fun, because we got to sit down with Brian Howes, which is an amazing songwriter and producer.
And it was in the Hollywood Hills, so it was pretty cool.
We were in the Hollywood
Hills. I was going to ask, where did you film that? It looked like you were in Cuba.
Oh, no, yeah, the video is.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, you wrote it in Hollywood.
But we wrote it, yeah.
You wrote it in Hollywood and you filmed the video in Cuba?
Yeah.
You guys are superstars. That is so much fun.
Yeah, that was probably the most fun for me.
Yeah, I think because that was our first big recording, too.
It was.
So we were all excited about it. And
working
it was
with somebody of that stature.
Yeah.
It was really... It was an honor. It was fun.
It was an experience.
Huh. All right. And next up, Kelly Dayton.
Kelly Dayton.
Oh.
Emma.
Oh. Emma. Got her daughter Emma.
Emma. How's it going, Emma?
If you weren't magicians, what would you be doing right now?
That's a really good question.
If I wasn't a musician, a lot of people probably know, but I'd probably be fishing. like crazy. I think one day when I get too old to move my arms to play the drums, I'll just sit in a chair with a fishing rod and just fish all day.
I think I probably would have moved south somewhere, maybe like Costa Rica, and just lived a simple life and had really tan, leathery skin. And just kind of like sit on the beach all the time. Maybe play some music down there as well. But I would be a beach bum probably, to be honest.
I'm not a bad car job. Driver. Ooh, this is cool.
I was going to school to be a paramedic before I joined 11 Past 1.
Wow.
So I would probably
have that.
Oh. I would probably open a business.
Nice. I
would be a video game business.
What kind of business, Petey?
Maybe a video game business. Yeah, that would be a video game business.
Something you open up a little pawn shops selling video games and knickknacks.
All those old used games.
That'd be fun. Maybe I could come work for you.
Or a franchise. You might run a franchise.
Yeah.
So many options.
Yeah,
all right, so since you're not fishing and tanning and race car driving, and now you're here together, how did you guys get together? How did this all happen?
Steven and I are brothers.
Kind of had no choice there.
Yeah, we met Steve in high school. Steve and Steve were in the same grade.
Yep. And then, yeah, we met each other. There's a long story to it, but there was a school fire, and he lived further away from the school than I did. So he came over to my house, and I had some instruments set up in the basement. We started jamming, and then he said, yeah, my brother sings, and we started all jamming. And then Beatty, I found him on Kijiji. He found me on Kijiji kind of thing. It was
from New Brunswick.
It was on eHarmonia.com.
No, it wasn't, man. Come on, it was Tinder. It was Tinder.
But, yeah, he was looking for a band, and, yeah, after a while.
You glad he swiped right? Is it right?
Yeah, you got his.
We were looking for a bassist, okay, and we found him on Kijiji.
And he moved here from New Brunswick, and wow.
And Kyle, Kyle, we found him through a mutual friend of mine.
I played in a band years ago with a buddy and his older brother, his older sister actually.
She was actually my prom date too.
Yeah, I remember her.
So we're all connected.
Shout out to Jess King.
Yeah, hey. Jessica King.
Yeah. Shout out to Starbucks,
Brooklyn, Ontario.
Oh, yeah.
All right, I think I learned a lot about you guys in the last 5 minutes.
Good questions,
minutes.
Guys.
I know who you're fishing with.
I enjoyed that. I enjoyed that thoroughly.
All right, so we've been doing a lot of talking. Let's do a little more playing.
Yeah, let's do it.
You guys gotta do a live version of your new single, I'm Ready. Now, question, you came out with World Is Ours a couple, was it like 2 years ago?
Yeah, November 2012.
And they're both from the same EP, right?
Yeah, because we didn't make an EP when we released that, so we were then we got signed after that by Warner.
Nice.
And we decided to include that on this first EP since everybody loves it.
We do. Yeah. All right, and we love this new one too.
Cool. Cool. Glad you're digging it.
Let's play a lot.
All right, here we go. 11 past 1 live on Mix97.
All right.
Stay. So baby, right now is
and live in studio. That was 11 past 1, their new single, I'm Ready. Guys, that sounds even better live.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
That was amazing. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have left, but thank you so much for coming in.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, big thanks to all the fans here.
Thanks, guys. Woo! Also, I just wanted to say you can pick up our new EP. It's in stores and on iTunes, online, anywhere.
Sam the Record Man. Shout out to Sam the Record Man. He's got good taste, honestly. All right, thanks so much, guys, for coming in. Up next, we've got another live artist in studio. Jordan's going to be joining us.